Did you know that 2018 is the International Year of the Bird? Neither did I. But they know at the Thomas Crane Public Library, and Sally Owen is here to tell us about a two-part series that's coming up in September to talk more about birds, Sally. We're going to the birds.
That's right.
Yeah, how's it going?
Great, great.
How's the summer been going, actually, for you?
It's good. Yeah. At my last program, we had like 76 people come.
That's
great. Land of Enchantment on Wollaston Hill, the architecture.
So, very nice.
So it's good. So we're now in our, we've just finished our 18th year of these monthly nature and historic tours in Quincy.
That's great.
So it's exciting.
Yeah.
So in September, mm-hmm. we are going to be working with the library and the South Shore Bird Club in a two-part program celebrating the 100th anniversary of the Migratory Bird Treaty Act of 1918.
Okay.
Back then, you know, people were, you know, killing birds, selling feathers, all this kind of thing, and the birds weren't protected. So a treaty was formed between the U.S. and Canada, and later Mexico and other countries, Russia, the U.K. got involved, and so now you can't kill birds, take their nests or any of that thing for certain species of birds.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're celebrating that. There's a really great birding place in Quincy. It's Passinagesset at Broad Meadows. And the South Shore Bird Club is going to be leading a tour there. That'll be Christine Whitebread and Les Tyrala. And it's going to be on Sunday, September 23rd at 9 o'clock.
Okay.
And we're going to be meeting in the parking lot of the Quincy Youth Hockey Arena, which is off C Street on what's called 60 Murphy Memorial Drive. If people have binoculars, they should bring them. The place is gorgeous anyway. If you can, you can come even if you don't have binoculars. There's beautiful signs out because this was an area where Native Americans had a habitat or, you know, were involved in some activities and things like that.
Yes.
There's some nice signs around there about
yep.
them. But it's also by the Cornell ornithology people. It's like this area is called a hot spot for birding.
Oh, interesting.
Many different species of birds have been found there. So it's a real treasure that we want to highlight. And then on Tuesday, September 25th at the library at 7 o'clock, this is going to be the Quincy premiere of this showing of a very inspiring film about three different men who've worked to protect three different endangered birds. One is Norm Smith, who's over at the Trailside Museum.
Mm.
He's actually head programs at the library. He's been working banding snowy owls to try to learn about them. So he is one of the three people that's going to be shown the film. And then this other person is Tom Sayers, who has been working to protect kestrels. In fact, the South Shore Bird Club and Mass Audubon have put up a couple of bird boxes in our park, Passinagesset, to try to track kestrels because they are really declining.
Hmm.
And then the third person on the movie is someone who's working to protect Atlantic puffins, and his name is Stephen Kress, who's been working for 40 years to protect Atlantic puffins up in Maine. And Shawn, Carey, who is the director of this film, is actually going to be at the library to introduce the film, show the film, which has never been shown in Quincy, and to answer any questions people have about it.
Sure.
So it's a very, very exciting program.
Yeah, the movie is called A Wing and a Care.
Yes.
Which I thought was very clever, yeah.
Yeah, so it's 7 o'clock on Tuesday, September 25th.
Okay, and that's at the main branch, right?
Yeah, the main branch community room downstairs.
Okay,
yeah.
But the tour is that the previous Sunday morning.
Right.
Passinagesset Park, I think, is
yeah, hard to say it.
Yeah, it is hard to say. And it was
the Native American word, yeah.
That's right. Restored by the Army Corps of Engineers, right? And not
yes,
too recent.
Yes,
project.
Yeah, we had a program with the people who, you know, tried to restore that, you know, so have worked to restore that march. It's a work in progress.
Right.
It takes quite a long time.
Yep, but there are some nice trails,
but,
as you mentioned, some benches.
Yes, and I think there's a group in Quincy, some conservancy, I can't think of it, Park Conservancy.
Yep.
And they're working to put in some plantings and, you know, also increase the beauty of the park.
Yes, so, yeah, there is a longer term plan.
So it's a really, I would encourage people to, if they can't come to the program, to go and check out this beautiful park.
Sure.
You can access it from behind Broad Meadows Middle School,
yep.
their paths, and there's also paths from that ice hockey rink,
okay.
which is where we're going to meet.
And if you don't have binoculars, at least bring a camera, right? Take some great photos.
Sure. And we'll be sharing binoculars. We'll probably have a couple extra pair.
Sure.
So.
And we'd kind of be taking notes of, you know, what you spot and sharing information afterwards?
I think that's what the South Shore Bird Club does with their programs. They make a list of everything, and then they, if you give them their, your email address, they will send them send you a list of what birds we saw that day.
Okay. And then again, the movie is that following Tuesday evening. But do you know how long the movie is, Sally?
I don't.
Okay.
I don't know how long it is.
Okay. Well, the program
I'm the whole program, you know, with him talking and everything, I'm sure it's going to be at least an hour.
A couple of hours, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So bird enthusiasts or nature lovers
or just people who want to find about what's happening in Quincy.
In Quincy, right, exactly.
Every time I run these programs, people like this Wollaston Hill program, I and my Patty Williams, who led the tour with me, neither of us had ever seen these gorgeous houses, all different architectural types on Wollaston Hill.
Yeah.
And so every time people come on these programs, oh, I've lived here all my life. I never knew this existed.
Yeah.
And the same is going to be probably the Pasiganasset Park.
Sure. You know?
It's just a gem that people should learn about.
Well, most people see the city through behind the wheel of the car, you know,
right,
so you just
kind
of things pass by and you don't really take note of them. So you're talking about the Environmental Treasures Program, right?
Yes, and I just want to let people know if they, we have email that we send out every month of what our tours are. So if you call 617-472-0799. You can leave a message of your email address and we will put you on our email list and you'll learn about all of our programs. They are also usually publicized in the Ledger and the Sun.
Right.
And if you don't have email, our postcards can be sent out to people if you give me the address.
Okay. So, and we post the information here, too, at Quincy Access Television.
Great. So really appreciate that.
Yeah, absolutely. But again, for this particular program, it's your Big Backyard Bird Walk and a two-part program. This is coming up on Sunday, September 23rd at 9 a.m. You are to meet at the Quincy Youth Hockey Parking Arena right on Murphy Street off C Street and head on out into Pasiganasset Park. And then the movie premiere here in Quincy, A Wing and a Care, is Tuesday evening. That's September 25th at 7 o'clock at the main branch of the Thomas Crane Public Library. Sally, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Great to see you. If you'd like more information about this or any of the programs at the library, just go to their website, thomascranelibrary.org.
Snowy owls, Atlantic puffins, American kestrels. Each of these remarkable birds is a marvel of evolution, supremely adapted to the rigors of life in its chosen environment. The windswept Arctic tundra, the North Atlantic's frigid waters, and North America's once vast prairies and grasslands. These three species share an ability to survive and have some basic characteristics in common, but on the surface at least, the similarities end there. Lifestyles, habits, habitats, all are distinctly different. Look a little deeper though, and you'll find that they're connected by something more, a link beyond any resemblance of form or function. A crucial thread ties these birds together. Each one has an advocate dedicated to its survival, to protecting it, speaking up about its plight, and, in the case of puffins and kestrels, using breeding programs to help pull it from the brink of disaster. They are Norman Smith with the Snowy Owl Project, Dr. Stephen Kress with Project Puffin, and Tom Sayers with his Northeast Connecticut Kestrel Project. Three men who share a vision to create a better future for the birds they love. Through their dedication, tireless work, and a passion for the species they protect, you will discover how one person can make a huge difference in the life of a bird. And you'll learn that if we choose to take action, to get involved ourselves, each one of us can drive bird conservation forward and play a critical role in helping safeguard the wildlife around us.